Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about different Docker commands which we have to run to interact with the Docker daemon process, like getting the set of images, getting the containers, stopping the container, starting the container, building a Docker file, creating the image and then running the image to create a container. Okay, these are all different set of commands you will understand. Okay, simply you can run Docker search. If you just search a Redis particular image, then you can see all the Redis image available on system. If you just see node, you will get a lot of image. Some are official image, some are the public image pushed by different developers. You can see the list. It's very big. Okay. Another thing is Docker run. So this we have already seen that how it works is what we do is Docker run. Interactive in the terminal mode, and we are actually specifying Ubuntu, so it will take the latest image and /bin/bash. So what it is doing is it will look, do we have a Ubuntu image? No, then it will pull that image, then it will run that particular container for us and will open the bin bash terminal inside the container. So currently we are inside the container, right? So Docker run minus it. In the interactive mode, Docker run is actually used to create a container from the image. Ubuntu is an image. If Ubuntu image is not available, then it will pull that image. It will, and then it will build the container from it. Okay. Now other commands are like Docker run, which is actually used to create a new container. Now we see Docker ps minus a all. Okay. We exit. And here we can see all running containers. Now what I can do is Docker container stop and the container ID. We can just pass the container ID here. And then we can remove it also, Docker rm. This container will be removed. Docker images, what all images we have. Docker rmi, a particular image ID. So in this case, if this image ID is not occupied by any of the container, then it will be deleted. Okay, similarly, this image ID, you can delete it. But you can see, this particular image is actually being used by this container, right? So what I can do is Docker container stop. Even I can simply remove this container. Then I can remove that image, right? Clear. So Docker images again, because I see a lot of dangling images are there. There is a simple command to remove all the dangling images. Docker rmi, remove particular image if this is occupied by some container. So Docker container stop and pass the container ID and then Docker rm container. Then just you can now delete this image. What happens? Must be force image is being used by this container. We have to, okay, this container might be regenerating. Docker container stop. Docker rm the same container. Now I should be able to, okay, this 43, I mean this container is regenerating, that is fine. So Docker ps all the active and dead containers. So now these containers, so we can just simply do Docker container prune. If you are getting irritated by these commands, you just remove all the containers. Docker image prune, I mean you should avoid doing this. It will actually remove all dangling images. And that is fine, I can have a clear set of images. Now I have only clear. Docker, similarly we have Docker volume prune. In coming videos we will see what this volume means, what is the network means, what is all these things. Okay, currently we are creating the containers, these are stateless. We are creating container, we are destroying, right? They are not storing any volume. But in future we will need containers who are actually need storage to store some database, store some caching keys, store some content in it, right? So we have to do the volume mapping, because host is the only operating system which has a storage, right? So with the help of these C groups and namespaces, container will be able to access particular part of volume on the host operating system, and we'll be able to do the volume mapping. Okay, so in this video we are just talking about the command, so let's focus there. So we have seen these commands: docker stop one or more running container, docker container stop. You can also use docker container start, docker run, is actually used to create a new container. Okay, so docker rm container name, it will remove the container. Docker update with the new configuration, you can do it. Start a container, docker start container. Okay, so every container gets an ID when you run it. So like if I just run docker run redis, right, redis is actually a container, so it will run it. But if I just do control C, it is actually exited, right? So this container, it comes in exit state, right? Because I have exited. Otherwise, if you just wanted to keep it running, then you can run this. Now we are inside a Docker container, Redis container, and it is actually ready to accept the connections. You can see here. But you will not be able to access the Redis here. You have to expose something from this container so that your host can talk to, or other container can talk to this. Okay, so Docker restart, Docker pause, Docker start, stop. These are same set of commands to start, stop containers. Okay, Docker build. This is actually to build a Docker file. So you have a Docker file. Consider that. Okay, let me show you. So I have this particular Docker file. Now what I will do is, I will just do a docker build -t. Docker build -t, that is name. I can specify name here. It should be like this only. I mean, just to provide the particular name. Okay, so what it is doing is, I think it should be only this one. So we are creating actually, this is actually name for this container, and docker build dash means it is actually looking for the docker file in the current working directory, and it is actually building that and giving us the container for us. Okay, so once this is done, we should be able to see a docker image created, and then we can run that container to actually have it as a container. So once we get the image, you can just do docker run that image ID, it will create a container out of it. Okay, docker pull, we have used it. Docker pull Ubuntu, docker pull Node.js, docker pull Redis, is actually pull the image from the docker hub, and in the docker registry there is an entry of this particular image. Similarly, docker push. Okay, these commands we have seen, docker ps minus a list, both running and dead containers which have been stopped or exited. Docker logs and container. In application development, we have to look at the logs also. So docker logs and container ID you can do, and you can check the logs for that container. Okay, now if I just do, okay, I can use this terminal. Docker images, nginx mine, right? So this is image ID you got. So what you can do is docker run this image ID. It will actually run the nginx. That is a different thing, we are not exposing it. So currently we are not doing any port mapping and volume mapping, means it will just run the nginx web server in this container. It's not exposed to the outside world, right? Now how we will do that, that we will take a look into next sessions. So if you just see docker ps minus a, we got all these containers. We can just actually check the log of a particular container. Maybe some other container. Yeah, you can see the Redis container is showing the logs. This is how it started. Okay, Docker network. By default, when you actually, currently we are not using Docker networks, but when you actually create a multiple containers, then Docker by default gives us a container. Currently, what we do is docker ps minus a. Then we can actually inspect these particular containers, and we will be able to see the network configuration of individual containers. These are getting an IP by themselves, and we can actually access the Docker containers from the IP also. Okay, Docker volume. Now, most important thing is we are actually creating a stateless Docker containers. We are creating Docker containers which are just an instance of image that is getting created and destroyed. What if your Docker container is having some database and wanted to store some data, right? How we can persist the data? For that, the volume came into the picture. Okay, you can create the volume, Docker volume, list volume, you can inspect the volume, you can list down all the volumes consumed by all the containers, and we are running volume pruning to free up all the volume consumed by different containers, used or unused. Okay, so Docker run, we want to Docker run Redis. What it is doing, it is actually pulling the Redis image and then creating container from that image. Similarly, this is also doing the same thing. You can also do Docker run minus it Redis and bin bash. In that case, it will actually start the container and will give you, will execute that bin bash command and will present a shell for you to access the container. Okay, so these are the basic Docker commands which we will be using everywhere in the whole series.